The roller delayed operating system is very similar to the roller locked system, but not actually the same. Roller delayed found its origins in World War II Germany as the result of some experimentations by Mauser engineers. While attempting to simplify a roller locked design, they unintentionally discovered roller delayed blowback. In a locked system, the two rollers are set on flat surfaces of a locking piece like this. In a delayed system, they're actually set on angled surfaces, as you see here. When this locking piece is fully inserted into the bolt head, it pushes these two rollers out into matching recesses in a trunnion or receiver, where they hold the bolt fully closed. Note that when the locking piece is all the way inserted, the rollers are resting on that angled section, not the straight section. When the gun fires, the cartridge case pushes backwards on the breech face here. That attempts to move the entire bolt assembly backwards. However, the two rollers in their recesses prevent it from moving. Instead, in order for the rollers to retract into the bolt head, the locking piece has to move backwards. The locking piece is in turn locked into the bolt carrier assembly, which has substantial mass. With the two angled surfaces acting as levers, this forces a significant delay as the bolt carrier is forced to move backwards with the locking piece before the bolt head can retract and extract the empty cartridge. The advantages to roller delayed systems are that they tend to produce very simple firearms that are easily compatible with stamped sheet metal receivers like this one. This was a primary consideration when the system was developed during World War II, and it carried over into production after the war. The downsides tend to be that it is a very dirty system that is not particularly conducive to use with suppressors, as often required by modern military forces. Like other delayed blowback actions, roller delayed systems tend to open at relatively high chamber pressure and thus often require secondary measures like chamber fluting in order to facilitate reliable extraction. The roller delayed system is seen primarily in rifles, although it has also been applied to a small number of handguns. It has been experimented with in machine gun designs, although none of those actually reached commercial viability, although for no real fault of the system itself. Hopefully you've learned something about roller delayed blowback today. I'm Ian McCollum for Forgotten Weapons. Thanks for watching.